Mic here, one go short play. Possibly with my microphone too loud, but hopefully not. And we are playing Bonkers for the Sega Mega Drive. Disney, eh? Never even heard of it. Where did this game come from? Straight out of the blue, that's where. Why would I not have heard of a Disney game? Ooh, I see. So we've got to pick a criminal to chase. Let's start at the beginning. Harry the Handbag is apparently wanted. Why have I never heard of this? This is a Disney game. We should all have heard of Disney games. Steal two treasures. Yeah, okay. Oh, I see we're running animation here. We can't skip this. Better throw donuts to stop in this tutorial. Be careful, they throw back. Good luck. Okay. Donut. Right. Duck and donut. It could be that it's not very good. Already, I quite like the look of this. Where are they? Ooh. Pyong. Ah, pyong, pyong. Got ya, right, they're coming toward. Come on then. Let's be having ya. Why can't I shoot? This is like that bonus level on Shinobi. Except I can't. Oh, go away. Take your little thieving hands off me goods. What are you doing? Get off. I see. So if you get them before they get to the exit, yeah, your goodies go back. Ah, have that. I don't know what I'd be ducking from. Why I've got a duck button, I don't know. Die, die, scumbags. Have I got infinite donuts? I'm having him. It appears I have. Oh, yeah. Yes, down you go. Thieving little scumbags. I think I did lose a couple of goodies there. Next round, is it the same again? Is it? It is. I think maybe the whole game consists of this. But I might be wrong. Let's find out. Raccoon, raccoon. Hey, it's good though. I'm quite enjoying it. It's solid. It's got a weird thing in that if you're moving and you press the fire button, it doesn't stop to fire. You know, one command doesn't override another. Have that. I saw you pretending to be a bunny. One command doesn't override another, so that'll do. So if you're pressing left or right and then you hit fire, he doesn't stop to shoot and then carry on running. Does that make sense? He just carries on running. You've got to let go of the movement button. And that feels a little bit... See, I'm pressing fire now. Alright, he does it occasionally. It feels a little bit amateurish on the control front there. It's not. It's imperfect. And let's face it, some of the sort of budget of Disney should be able to enlist someone who's got a bit of a better grip on the control mechanics. It's very good. What is there is very good. The left-right movement feels good. The animation around the shooting movement feels great. Oh, no, you don't. Put that back. And yeah, the actual animation itself is fine. The game design feels a little limited. I was expecting a platformer, obviously. You know, judging by the look of the character. Oh, hello. And there is one. Brilliant. I'm glad to see that. Because I wouldn't want it to... Oh, no! To just be about shooting up into the screen. It's like... Oh, maybe that was a bonus stage. It was. All right, we live and learn. Those things fall if you stay on. Oh, it is. Do you know what it's like? It's like the reverse of a Shinobi game. So where... I think I like this. So where we've got platform levels in Shinobi as actual game content. See, that's what you're ducking. Big pink donuts. We've got in Shinobi platform levels as the main game content with actual design to the platform bit, you know. This, and then you've got the shooty bit where you shoot the ninjas with less design as the bonus stages. This does it the other way around, so these shooty levels appear to be the actual levels, and I'm just admiring the parallaxing just at the back there. Yeah, and the platform levels are the bonus levels. I'm guessing with less design. That's how it appears on my first one go short play. Come on now. Yeah, that'll do. And yeah, that's cool. So bats, something to do with bats. No, maybe not. Maybe they were just there for show. Just kill the stone thing. I'm guessing they're bonuses of some sort. We'll kill them. No! I wonder how much damage you take from a donut. Well, there's the bat. Oh, he's getting me. Oh, no. Yeah, there's proper more going on now. I'm tempted to get hit by a donut just to, oh no, he stole my apple, just to see what happens. No, you don't. I appear to have hearts at the side there, which I'm guessing is help. Those bats are going to be a pain, aren't they? I'm going to loathe those bats by the time we're done here, I think. They are just getting in my way. Oh, you little pooey bat. Ow! It's good, though. It is good. It's decidedly more substantial than those ninja levels on Shinobi. What an interesting angle to take for a Mega Drive game. Maybe that's why I've not heard of it and it clearly hasn't done that well. Oh no, that one bat just battered me. See what I did? Battered. See what I did? Never mind, no. It's really not that important. It looks like we're starting the level again because the bonus items are there again. All our treasures back. No, you don't. Oh, you dirty little raccoons. I got hit by a donut that you may have noticed. It's basically the same as getting hit by a bat. You go out, you react, and you lose a bit of health. No, there's nothing there for you, mate. And you're not having that, I can tell you that now. Oh, and you're not having that either. You'll die before I let you have that. Just shoot the pillars so they can't hide. If you can blow up stone with your donuts, little logic there somewhere, I'm sure. What's to stop you shooting the pillars? Ah, donut in the face. I'm not sure where the logic comes that donuts make a good weapon. It's all a bit random. Maybe the style of game was just not, standard recognisable enough for a console game. And that might be why I've never heard of it, and I'm sure I'm not the only one. Considering that it's a Disney game and they're usually quite popular. Down you go. It's good. I'm kind of a bit bored of the format, if I'm honest. Oh no. I can see how they're doing the same but harder, you know. It'd be nice if maybe those levels, you know, this is like the handbag guy or whatever he's called. It'd be nice if the other levels were completely different games, and maybe they are. So I wouldn't be too quick to judge this one just yet, because I keep losing that apple first, don't I? Oh no, he's nicking me shoe. Oh, he's nicking me. No, you don't. Me Aladdin thingy, me lamp. That's the word. So there's a lot of Disney paraphernalia in this game. I don't recognise any of the characters. Is this character in any of the cartoons? Ow! Answers on a postcard. Oh, I got hit and did it at the same time. That guy looks vaguely familiar. I'm sure he's not out of anything though. Maybe it's just the style he's drawn. It's alright. Let's see a bit more of this bonus level. I'm hoping to actually get a bit further. The platforming's a little bit rough. It's a little bit rough. I think that's meant to be though, because you know the challenge therein lies and all that. Graphics good, platforming's alright. There's just a few little snags to the controls, that whole thing about not being able to shoot while you're moving very effectively. That's the only real problem with the controls. Oh, what are you doing? Get off me! Ah, Mad Hatter, he's the Mad Hatter. Hey, we've got a Disney character. He's going down though. Not having that. Right. Oh, he's back. Well, stop coming and get me. I get you, that's how it works. Oh, he's proper trounced me. Right, I'm guessing we don't want to be shooting those now. Let's just see what happens if we shoot him. Yeah, he dies. Graciously. He doesn't. Alright, he comes to get you if you shoot him. So, we don't want to be shooting the Mad Hatter. Oh no. We live and learn. Will he go away if I leave him alone? Oh no, there's two of them. Nicking me stuff. Nicking me lucky charms. Die. No, he's getting me apple. No, you don't. You're not having me apple. And you're certainly not having my beautiful ruby slipper, glass slipper, whatever. There's like a weird slight parallaxing going on in the back layer that I really like. It gave me the impression that the whole game parallaxed a bit. It doesn't. The whole game is one layer, except for that background layer. But that having that background layer parallax just gives a nice impression of more depth than there really is. And I like that. It's a nice illusion. Oh, wow, there's loads of raccoons, man. I'm so dead. Right. We're 10 minutes in. I must be enjoying this because I lost track of time just a little bit there. It's not bad, that. I don't know if it's like a 40 quid console game. I think by today's standards it's more of a... you know, an online minigame with very nice graphics. It doesn't feel substantial enough to be a Mega Drive game. Not that I don't like it. I won't be seeking out the cartridge for this one. But it's alright. So there we go, that's Bonkers for the Sega Mega Drive. Thanks very much for watching.